Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back for 2014 version of your SSN Men's Hockey. Tonight we have the McGill Redmen taking on your Ottawa Gigi's here at the Metro Sports Complex in Ottawa, Ontario. Gigi's coming off a strong end to the first part of their season. The first part of the season started off slow, but picked it up. Had an amazing November, and looking to continue that success into that new year. I'm Richard Kennedy, always with Renee. Renee, how are you doing tonight?
I'm doing well tonight. Thanks, Rich. Yeah, we're facing a strong team here. Ottawa coming in fifth, looking to move up the rankings past Carleton with the win here, facing McGill, who's 12-5-1 for second in the OUA East. Just getting ready for a puck drop. Redmen ball can't quite win that. McGill. They've had a strong season so far this year. Oh, blows a tire there. Ottawa scores! Right away. Great start. 15 seconds in.
Bam, that is the fast start that they wanted to get out on McGill tonight. This is a crucial game for them to win. It's a four-point game, as Coach was explaining to me earlier. I'll get to that later. But Ottawa U jumps out to a quick 1-0 lead. Wow. I don't even have time to have a sip of my coffee right now.
Yeah, that was really number five, Carrier, fell and gave Ottawa that opportunity real quick. So 1-0 Ottawa.
The Redmen look a little shaken up right now, not expecting that quick opening attack. Come out flying here.
Some discussion. A little discussion with the referees and the Ottawa bench. McGill coming off the loss on Wednesday. They lost 6-4 to UQTR, so certainly looking to change that around. Ottawa coming off a win, 4-2 versus RMC. Moving it up here. It's intercepted by the Redmen. Just going to slow it down. Back to the defenseman. Interestingly, the Redmen's leading scorer is a defenseman. Number 8 from the States.
Well, it's all crucial where you can get the scoring. And here's a shot. Wow, by Matt White. Ripped it wide. But it's always crucial to have a defenseman that can jump into the play. And you need that strong offensive D-man to be part of your team today. You want to see some success on the ice.
And for Ottawa, a lot of the scoring coming from number 21, Stephen Blunden. He's got 10 goals, 15 assists so far this season. As the Redmen pinned in their end right now, trying to get it out, and they do. It's intercepted.
Really like the way Blunden plays, especially in November. You can see he was one of those key guys that really stepped up his game and started being able to put the puck in the net and contributed to that strong month.
Tanguay-Thériau dumps it in and goes to Chase. He has 4 game-winning goals so far on the season, so certainly a big player for Ottawa.
Captain Clutch, they should call him. Always there for the big game.
It's going to be dumped in by Comtois, and he'll give chase himself, but brought out by Blunden. And goaltender Saint-Laurent will come out to play it around. It's our first home game back in 2014.
2014, you mean. Anyways, the starting goaltenders tonight. Missed that already. Number 30, Warren Shimko, is net for the Gigi's. And number 30, Jacob Gervais-Chouinard for the Redmen. So two pretty well-played goaltenders right here. Strong. Oh my God, looking at McGill's percentage, 1.96. And the switch up right there. And it's going to be number 35, Carol Saint-Laurent is net for the Redmen.
Big hit here. We're going to have a penalty, it looks like. Interference penalty to Ottawa's Mathieu Leduc. So a chance for the Redmen here to tie it up, go on the power play.
Leduc is taking the walk of shame into the sin bin. Yep, for the first time, so we're going to see the shorthanded unit come out. Penalty kill. And this is a crucial time for the Redmen to respond with a quick goal of their own.
McGill, 23.8% on the power play, one of the best in the league. Ottawa, 83 0.6% on the penalty kill. So we'll see if they can hold on here, keeping McGill to the outside as they work it around. Nice pass there. Shot is blocked. And got a player down for Ottawa. Gertin took that in an awkward spot. The rookie limping on one leg, can't get up.
He's struggling. He's bent over. He can't move.
Fluché, great block there by him to keep it to the outside. Knocks down McKiernan. Gertin really in pain, cannot do anything. Really need a stop here by Shimko so we can get fresh legs on the ice. Redmen keep pushing.
You got to appreciate the heart of Gertin right now, staying on that ice right now, even if he's hurt.
And Gertin making his way to the bench as he is helped off and finally get fresh legs on. Ottawa no worse for wear so far. As Donovan comes on, picks that up, and he'll dump it in and chase, give Ottawa a chance to change. Killed off over a minute of this penalty. So the Redmen will regroup, bring it back up.
Oh!
Laid out there by Terrier.
Sit out.
Great hit.
Pop
high, just completely laid out.
Certainly made the fans here in front of us happy with that big hit.
And they'll try again. Ottawa clears the zone. Redmen will regroup. Boutet, he slows it down. That's intercepted, knocked down by Tanguy Thériault, who comes in. Nice shot. That'll be saved by Saint-Laurent. Redmen giving the puck away a lot. Great opportunity there as Blunden threw it in front, but White couldn't quite finish.
Yeah, seeing some sloppy.
I think we're going to have an unsportsmanlike penalty here.
Really? Uh-oh. Looks like the Redmen will be shorthanded now.
Yeah, unsportsmanlike for shooting the puck into the netting after the offside whistle.
And they're already having trouble. Notice early on now, we're almost 5 minutes in this game, and you can see the Redmen are a little shaky in their own zone, running around a bit, and we're seeing right now Gertin getting taken to the dressing room.
So it's that left foot he can't put any weight on. So now Ottawa's power play will go to work, 23% on the season. McGill running 85% on the penalty kill. We'll see what Ottawa can do here. They certainly got the momentum. Fouché brings that around. Now Huck Malkui picks a hard hit. And that long pass for Ouellette is out of his reach. Saint-Laurent passes it around to his defenseman. They've got hard pressure on them. Ottawa can't quite get set up, but Leduc keeps it in. Seeing a different power play look from Ottawa. Earlier in the season, they were running four forwards and one defenseman. Now they've got both Leduc and Terrier on. So trying something different here.
I think I credit that too. We can see Ottawa has a great mix. They have some solid offensive defensemen. Leduc and Burns, I'd say, and Terrier for sure. Three guys that can really jump into the play and make a difference. So I'm wondering if the coach is giving them a chance to see what they can do and open up.
Yeah, Leduc actually fifth in scoring on the team. 2 goals, 11 assists so far. So definitely making his contribution known. So not only a 2-minute penalty, but a 10-minute misconduct for tossing the puck up into the netting.
Wow. That is wow.
Officials not in a good mood tonight.
No. The player must have said something as well, but who knows. We've got informed there's a lack of pucks. So we have to conserve. 2014, that's a hard year for everyone. Economy's rough.
Crown Bill, he goes back to get it. He didn't play much in the end of November, so good to see him back on the ice here. Playing with Landry.
It's good to see these boys back to full strength. And, looking at the first half of the season, I asked Coach Faymon today, I said, what's what's your thoughts in the first half of the season? And he said, really, you know, everyone's asking the same thing. What happened at the start compared to the second half? And he put it down to commitment to defense, where guys really able to step up and play the D well, and also the return of injured players such as Goucher, Vermette, and, you know, having their captain back, that proved to be a huge boost.
Yeah, we really saw a big difference in the play. They settled down, the line settled down, and they got used to playing with each other once Fouché came back. I think they only have something like two losses with him in the lineup, so definitely a great leader.
Exactly, and even having, you know, they have that two goalie, that double tandem of May and Shimkoe, and we've seen Shimkoe kind of emerged as the starter. So, you know, goaling it's not really a controversy. Both guys are battling out and want to play their best, so Ottawa needs it.
Vermette here, he keeps that in. Fouché, his shot gets deflected into the corner, so we see the same four top defenseman pairings. Fouché, Vermette together, and the Dickin, Therrien. London, he throws that across, it gets knocked down. Nice long pass there.
Give credit to the Redmen right now. They're really trying to open up the ice and convert these long passes.
Yeah, Rose was in the corner. He gets stripped of the puck, and now Tanya Thériault moved that up the other way. He's looking for Blunden in the middle, but dumps it in and goes off for the change. Blunden has white in front, and Thériault comes in. Big shot, big rebound, but the Red... Oh! Big hit in the middle of the ice. Wow. Donovan just comes in, and boys are awake tonight.
Wow, that was a big hit.
White bringing it in. Clearly excited to play in front of their home crowd again. It's been over a month, so lots of step.
These boys are not showing any mercy tonight. Throwing the body like it's going on sale.
Donovan moves that up. Redman dump it in. Get some fresh legs on. Prokop gave chase, but moved up quickly by Leduc up to Donovan, who'll dump it in. Ouellette throws it in front, and nice save by Saint-Laurent as the net comes off its moorings.
And we're about midway through the first period, and it's 1-0 here for the GGs taking on the Redmen. And interestingly enough, we're seeing a high intensity right now. Something hasn't left Ottawa. Big hits. Quick goal to come in the first 3 minutes of the game, and I'm really liking what I'm seeing from this GG team right now. Great opening. And it's a welcome back party for us, I guess, too, eh?
Yeah, it's exciting, certainly. And the stands have filled up here in the last couple of minutes. Boys are going to put on a good show, I guess.
We've got some young students down there with thundersticks. Who doesn't love thundersticks?
Vermette's shot gets picked up, and now the Redmen bring it up the other way with speed here. Beautiful shot by Ducharme. Big rebound, but Ottawa does a great job of clearing it up, and now defenseman Fouché carries it in. He'll get to the blue line, dump it in, and Ouellette collides with Ducharme, and they go right into the net.
On that last rush there, I give full credit to Marcoux for taking the man out of the picture, taking the McGill defenseman right out of the picture. There was not a chance he could get that into center ice. And a little collision down there.
Yeah, Saint-Laurent had to avoid the players there.
Watch out! Face-off right now.
Tanguy Thériault wins that. The Redmen pick it up, bring it back the other way. Got a...
goal scored.
Goal there, wow. Yeah, that was kind of a strange play. A 3-on-1 and Leduc trying to get back, but just a plain shot from the hash marks.
Little nice toe drag around and top shelf, top cheese to make this a 1-1 hockey game here. And we just saw right now number 15 gets in, skated back to the bench, and was on his own power. I wonder if he's staying in this game or just having a word with the coaching staff.
That kind of silenced the crowd. Strong rush by McGill, and they put it in to tie it up. 1-1 game. Certainly Ottawa's had most of the momentum here, but Layton. So Ottawa putting their fourth line on. Try and get the energy back here quickly. Power is in front. Sela has spins that around.
Ottawa's continuing this pressure play. They'd like to get that goal back because it kind of came as a shocker to everyone here. These McGill Redmen are not going to back down, that's for sure.
And Elise Hood tried to bring that in, got broken up, sent back the other way. And now McNicholy will try. Shot on net, and we're going to have another penalty here.
I believe it's going to go over to LeDuc there.
A hook.
Rough penalty to take, you know, you got to hate those stick penalties, high sticking, tripping, whatever, but, you know, LeDuc just trying to play the man and catch up, but.
LeDuc's second penalty of the game, giving the Redmen a chance to build on this energy here from that goal.
Well, LeDuc's been pretty behaved this entire season, so, I don't know, maybe he's got some things to work out right now. Spend some time alone in the penalty box.
Redmen going to regroup in their own end. Hard pressure there from Ottawa.
Solid forecheck right now by Touchette, who's trying to keep that puck in.
Lemieux shoots that right on net, deflected by Shimko. The leading scorer, McKiernan, here directing Lemieux. Back to McKiernan. He'll pass it over. Carrier. Oh. Lemieux was trying to sneak in the back door there. Can't quite hit him. And Donovan clears the zone. Redmen will try and get it set up again. It's carried in. The Lilhood. Back to McKiernan. He gets around White. Back to the point for Carrier. That was a nice block by Gertin, who seems to be okay. Good to see him back on the ice.
And amazing. First thing he does, come out and block a shot. Tell you what, that's good old hockey right there. Toughing it up and working through the pain.
So Ottawa dumps it all the way down. Redmen, 30 seconds to give it another go. Rose breaking in around for
Gertin.
And gets laid out. That's the third big hit of the game.
Good night, Irene. Wow. That was awesome.
Huge hit behind the net there on number 7, Rose.
Ottawa's just throwing the body
around. Yeah, definitely.
Around.
They're going for the hits. And they've killed off this second penalty. As Rose seems to be okay. And, oh, just after the penalty expires. Shot from the point is tipped by number 28, Daniel Hood.
That was a rough goal to go in. There's a weak tip. I bet you Shimko would love to have that back. We've not seen this from him before. Off to a little bit of a shaky start. And we have a 2-1 hockey game right now, midway through the first period. So, although Ottawa has stepped up on the physical play and have been really exciting us up here in the booth at least, they need to work a bit stronger on their team.
Yeah, Ottawa had a great start to the game and now find themselves down 2-1. So certainly not what the coach would like to see. Redmen certainly are able to quickly make something out of nothing. And Ottawa will have to watch out for that. So they send it back the other way now. See if they can even this game up. Got less than 8 minutes left in the first period.
Oh,
big screen in front, and Sela Ha gets knocked down. The net is off its moorings. Whistle's blown.
good for McGill to step in quick and make sure that Saint-Laurent is all right. You know me, I'm very critical of protecting our goaltender and that, and all those mistake play. You get a sea of red as soon as that happened to make sure he was all right. So
we hear the announcement. The goal was scored by number 28, Patrick Delisle-Hood. That's his fifth goal of the season. It's 11 assists. Saint-Laurent clears that out of harm's way. It's Ottawa putting pressure in the Redmen zone. McGill gets it out, carries it up. Good speed here. Duchamp. And Reginball, the rookie, carries it up the other way. He's been very good for Ottawa. 13 points on the season.
Oh,
great opportunity there. And the net, once again, coming off really easily so far this game.
They must have, we're short on pucks, and I guess we're short on super glue as well. We can get some duct tape down there. Call Red Green. You can duct tape the net down. But, some fancy passing going down in there on that nice break. Trying to make some momentum.
Looks like we will have another power play for Ottawa, perhaps. No. Just switching it up, fixing the net.
Hopefully that stays now.
It's come off a couple times so far. Saint-Laurent covers that quickly. It's Reginball trying to go right for the net.
You mentioned Reginball being the rookie. He's had a fantastic first year, I'd say.
Yep.
He's really developed a solid two-way player. And, that's a good sign for this season, but also for next future seasons as well. It's great for him to produce and continue his success.
Both him and Galtier in their first year and playing solid minutes for Ottawa. See Reginball go off here, something in his skate perhaps. And now McGill quickly brings it up the other way. Ducharme, that shot right in the helmet. Shimko, he'll stop that. Weak shot from the point, but McGill keeps it in. Ouellette tries to get it out. White helps him along. That's going to be brought back by Bernier. He's going to send it up. Leduc goes to get it. He's got hard pressure.
Ottawa's
nice
got a
long lead pass for White. He forgets the puck. And back the other way.
Ottawa's got to watch it a bit now. They're starting to throw the body a lot, but they got to watch not get taken that position.
It's a high-speed game. Both teams back and forth quickly. McGill moving it back now the other way. Oh, White takes the legs out from under Levesque, the McGill captain, and the bench not happy about that.
Dangerous play, and Whitey got away with a good one, but
Collins goes straight for the net. That stopped. They're digging in the corner now.
Oh.
Like a big hit from the back, but no call, and the 10-minute misconduct is up. As the Redmen get number 16, Alexis Millette, back.
Taylor Collins went to the boards right there for Ottawa. And David Light, from what I saw, a light shove to the Redmen player, and he went flying into the board. So they got a
good non-call, perhaps.
Yeah. I'm not down there. I'm not wearing stripes, so.
Tanguy Thériault rushes, keeps that in. Ottawa can't quite do anything with it. And that puck skips on Vermette. Oh, broken up by Fouché. Keeps calm. Keeps it to the outside. Shot from the point there by Lapolte. But Ottawa moves it up the other way. Tanguy Thériault trying to put some moves. Can't quite.
Playing it well down the boards right now as Ottawa's trying to make something of it.
Still 2-1 here for McGill after Ottawa opened up the scoring.
And getting back to what I mentioned earlier, I talked to the coach Faymon today, and he said it was a 4-point game. And after about, I'd say, 15 minutes of him explaining to me what that meant, because when you win, you get 2 points, I assume, but four-point game.
Get 2 points.
They are right locked with McGill, and there's 2 points separating these boys. So, you know, it'd be a big crucial win if they can get up there and pass McGill, because it's the second part of the season. You start thinking about playoffs. You start thinking about that. So, really, it's a good time. That streak really pushed Ottawa up. As I was talking to Bite today, he said, oh, Ottawa went on a run, eh? They did, and hopefully they can continue that success.
Great stop there. Landry breaks up that play. Some battle in the corner at Ottawa's end as Ouellette. He flips that up.
That was an excellent defensive play by Landry. Put some good blue-collar hockey right there. Laying the body where it needs to be.
Lévesque in alone here. Gets around Thierrien, but Leduc keeps him to the outside. Doesn't give him anywhere to go. Larocque-Marcoux. He'll end up with the puck. Carry that out. Got a player right on him. Ottawa dumps it in. A stop by St. Laurent.
Just about less than 5 minutes to go here in this first period. The score 2-1. And we can see both teams, yeah, they both are fired up now. And this is a back-and-forth affair.
Lemieux breaks right in. That's blocked by Shimko. The Redmen certainly getting some great opportunities here in the second half of this first period.
They are. They're continuing that force in front of the net. And got to love Shimko right there putting the hand out. Stop. Back away. So.
Well, yeah. Certainly what we've seen is that they have a great ability to just pick up the puck and make a great scoring opportunity from nothing.
Exactly. It's a very exciting first period so far that we're have the joy of watching and calling tonight.
McNichol here in to take the draw, and he wins that back to Rose. Oh, that shot goes off the post, and the rebound couldn't be put in by Rose. The net comes off the moorings, and the ref will blow it down. Great shot from the point by Boutette.
I give credit to the officiating right now, as they we're not taking anything tonight. They are strict on everything, and that whistle's being blown like nothing. So, but yes, that ping. Goalie's best friend or his worst enemy. Face off now.
Same as before. McNichol wins it back to Rose. But Ottawa gets control, gets it out. Tanguy Thériault, he moves in. Ottawa trying to get something going here in this last 3 minutes. Tie it up before they head to intermission. Touchette is fighting in the corner. Doesn't end up with the puck. And the Redmen get a tip on that, get it out. Boucher will go back to get it. Looking around, off the glass. It's intercepted. Millette. Now the Redmen moving back the other way. He'll circle back. Great passing there. Landry stepped up on Pompey and broke it up in Ottawa. Quick speed the other way. Donovan gets knocked down. And now we see McGill coming. Both teams very back and forth. Neither team really getting set up. We have a whistle here.
Intense play right now. And I'm looking at number 19, Pompey. That's Mathieu Pompey for the Redmen. It looks like he has a do-rag on or something like that. I'm not sure if that's his hair, but a big long ponytail coming from the back. Floating away as he skates down the ice. It looks pretty cool.
Ottawa wins the face-up. Larocque-Marcoux dumps it in. McGill, defenseman, flips it all the way down the ice. It's going to be covered up by Shimko as we've got hard pressure there by Lessier.
once again, the Redmen charging that net and creating that offensive presence. And they're getting another faceoff in Ottawa zone, and so lots of words being exchanged to these two teams as well. As you can see, there's not a lot of licking going around down there.
Strange play there. McNichol bats it back, and that'll be a hand pass.
Boys, you can use the stick, not your hands. It's just not.
Just batted it out of midair with his hand.
Pretty impressive, though. Good hand-eye coordination.
So. Minute and a half left here in this first period. Our first home game back here at the Minto Sports Complex. Najik passes that across, hard pass, and Regimal can't quite knock it down. Redman quickly move it back the other way. They've definitely got some speedy players. Regenball knocks down Rose, who's slow to get up. No call. Seems to be okay. Last minute play here in the first period as it gets whistled down.
And again, saying Ottawa U is taking advantage of that. Cramping down on... taking away that mid-ice, no passes or anything, and trying to keep them to the outside, because we've seen the Redmen can create scoring chances out of nothing. So it'd be interesting to see the adjustments over the intermission break.
Ottawa, that shot is high. Fighting for it, trying to get a good opportunity here, and that's going to be cleared out. Carrier over to Legic. Nice hard shot on net, and that will be stopped by Saint-Laurent.
Big solid save right there by Saint-Laurent, who is pretty a big, by goaltender standards, pretty big. 6'4", 197 pounds. So
I see it from here, much taller than your average goaltender.
So, imagine trying to get a puck through that. Well, have fun.
Well, Ottawa's gotten one by him and looking to get another one here as Tanguy Thériault will come in to take the draw. Shot from the point. Clear it up, and McGill once again doing a great job of bringing the puck the other way. It's Touchette. 3-on-2 the other way. He'll take a hard shot, and that'll go out of play.
Lots of whistles here in this first period as well.
Yeah, we're having trouble getting through this last minute.
Between the net coming off its spot and whistle here, there, back and forth. Started as high intensity here, but the whistles will keep breaking it up for sure.
Ottawa, 18 seconds to tie it up here. Can't quite get control of the puck. Ouellette goes in the corner, back to the point. Nice clean shot and saved by Saint-Laurent.
Solid job not giving up any easy rebounds right there. He's very good to keep the puck and to himself, not easy rebounds for a nice garbage goal, which would Ottawa love right now, going into the breakdown one. Have to claw their way back for a second period.
Officials are discussing the timekeepers, perhaps, about how much time is on the clock.
Having discussions right now, and I think they're ready to rock and roll. No, having a word with McGill's coach.
Ottawa has a two-game homestand so far, so playing tomorrow at 7 as well against UOIT.
Yeah, Université de Québec at Trois-Rivières, right? UIT? I thought it was. That'll wrap up the first period as we have a 2-1 affair between the Redmen and the GGs. We're going to go into the break right now. See what adjustments have been made for after that first period. We can see Redmen can make scoring chances at nothing, so hopefully Ottawa can tighten up the screws on defense, and we'll see you soon, folks. We are back here for the second period of action at the Mental Sports Complex in beautiful Ottawa, Ontario. The score right now is 2-1 for the McGill Redmen over the GGs. Exciting first period. We had lots of hits and some crazy goals scored just, you know, out of the blue. And what do you think are going to be the adjustments? We got, you know, Scrooge got tightened up on defense, Renee. What do you think?
I think that Ottawa's got to get ready for that quick rush by the Redmen. They certainly switch it up, set it back the other way, and Ottawa's got to be prepared for that. We had they opened the scoring really early, 14 seconds in, Lahoc Malcou scored, put Ottawa ahead, but then Redmen answered with two goals of their own, a goal by Rose, and then a nice tip by DeLille Hood. So 2-1 for McGill's where we sit, and second period is underway here. Legit, great shot from the point. Got a little pushing and shoving here. The intensity is still there, clearly.
See that Donovan getting right in the face, getting it right in the face there. Love that, though. Great start. Beautiful point shot from Leduc Clapper, and you can see Ottawa, white bodies in front of that net, bang away at those rebounds. So.
Yeah,
Garretian seems to be all healthy and ready to go, I guess.
Yeah, it's having a discussion with the official there. Sato will change its lines up. Maybe looking for another goal in the first minute here. Great play there. And Touchette fanned on the shot. Leduc comes in, and that'll be gloved by Salem, huh? Touchette standing on the doorstep waiting for the rebound. Certainly good pressure here from Ottawa. What they need to do is play a full 20 minutes. As McGill did get the better of them in that second half of the first period.
You see, yeah, McGill responded very well to Ottawa's quick outburst in the first.
McGill gets it out now.
Ottawa's breaking in right now. Dario, shot.
His shot's blocked. And he goes right to the net, trying to get the tip there, and the net comes off, and puck bouncing all over the place.
Now, Blunden's getting in the face of a few McGill players, and again, the net's knocked off. What a surprise.
Once again, yeah.
Tell ya. But, no, and one thing also we know in the first period as well, with Ottawa, the hits. Well, I think we saw three or four huge hits that are very entertaining and, you know, sets the tone, but they have to watch it because a couple of times they got caught and we're put out of position. So.
Now, certainly not like these teams have a huge rivalry. Last time they played at the beginning of the season, Ottawa lost 6-0 in McGill. So wasn't a close game. Certainly looking for a different outcome here. We've seen a stronger team since the return of Fouché. Rose now, he's got a goal already in this game. Moves it across. It's going to be dumped in by Prokop. And now the Redmen looking for an opportunity. Touchette will pick it up. Slow it down, Nijic. Comes out from behind the net. Looking around, he's got hard pressure. That'll be dumped in by Ottawa. And backhanded up high into the mesh by Boutier. He had hard pressure by Blunden, and Ottawa have a face-off in the Redmen end.
You can see Ottawa trying to work that long passes as well. Worked for McGill in the first, but it really opens up the ice and becomes a skating game. So McGill did a good job of creating that, playing their game that first period. Well, I think Ottawa's a team that really likes to come out and set the tone, and they want to play their game. They're playing GGs hockey, and McGill took that away from them in the first period.
Certainly McGill is a fast team. I wouldn't want to get into a speed game with them. They create rushes really quickly, so Ottawa needs to kind of clog up the middle. Boucher here comes in, keeps it in. Passes behind the net. Reginball can't quite keep a handle on it, and that'll be moved up the other way by Carrier. Dumped in by McGill. Shimko comes around to play it. Nice long lead pass for Ottawa. And once again, Reginball can't quite keep a handle on it. He picks it up, moves it over, La Roque Malcou, and that'll be offside for Ouellette. They couldn't quite communicate enough there.
And both, the entire league, you know, coming off a break, the last game was played, the last home game, or at least we were announcing, was played back in November that we saw. So, you know, CIS had a huge month break off, and we're seeing these teams, you know, maybe a bit rusty come off the start, but...
Yeah, they started back last week, both teams playing last weekend. McGill started off with a loss 3-2 to Carleton and then beat UOIT 4-2. And then, like we mentioned, coming off that 6-4 loss to UQTR on Tuesday. Ottawa last weekend, they had a 5-2 loss to Carleton.
Whoa.
And then a 4-2 win over RMC.
Ottawa getting leveled in their own zone. McGill's taking up the strong play as well.
Laporte here, he dumps it in. The gloves dropped by Fouché. Ottawa in their own end. Hard pressure there. Bernier on the puck. That'll be an icing call all the way back in Ottawa's end.
And yeah, Tim saw earlier was getting in the face of Saint-Laurent. He actually fell over almost onto him. And Saint-Laurent was having none of that. You can even see his shoulders shrug. Come on, buddy, stay on your feet. So
certainly
there is
a
no
big guy.
Love lost on these two teams.
Yeah, I know. Both teams playing hard. Certainly see why McGill is second in the standings. A very good team. Ottawa trying to even up the score here. 2-1 for McGill. Once again, another icing. So Ottawa, tired legs on the ice.
Ottawa's, like you said, we're home weekend. They're home for the weekend, the boys. They've got two games coming up. And, you know, it's playoffs. It's getting close to playoff time. They got 2 months left of hockey. So, really... liking what I saw from Ottawa as they closed out the season. Hopefully they can continue that strong form through and bring it into the playoffs.
Yeah, we're hoping it wasn't just Movember mustache luck. Hopefully continue the winning here in the new year.
They should have kept the mustaches. They should have kept the mustaches.
Some back and forth play here. Both teams trying to gain control. Galtea getting tangled up there in the middle. No call. Celera knocks it down, moves it quickly. McKiernan, leading scorer for McGill, the defenseman. Second in scoring for all defensemen in the league. So certainly doing his part for the team. Sterrier. He tries to move it from behind the net. Spins it back around. Ottawa gets it up. Nice pass here. And Tanguy Thériault just a bit out of his reach. And Touchette. Oh, loses control after a beautiful move. Tanguy Thériault shoots that high. Ottawa getting great chances, but just fumbling the puck a little bit.
Can't get his good. Get the final touch on it. That's a beautiful tap, tap, tap stick work there. But... couldn't pull it together.
High stick there, so you might be right. Maybe a little rusty after that time off the ice.
Well, and it's, like I said, they had a month off where it was, you know, regroup, get healthy, practice, and, you know, of course, also they're students at the same time, Renee. They're like us, we had to study for exams and that. But I think they're going to be back in here, and, you know, what we're seeing right now, yeah, it's, too excited, I guess an excitable boy right there in front of the net couldn't find a way to put it past the keeper.
Terrien here. Ottawa moves it up. Dumps it in. They'll go in to chase that. Collins. And once again, the Redmen keeping good control of the puck. That'll be brought up by Neil Blunden on McGill. Ouellette now, he gets hit hard. Can't get it out. McGill an opportunity.
McGill is not backing down, stepping with their own physical play right now in the second period, making a statement.
Yeah, some hard hits here, laying the body. McGill moving the puck around. They're set up in Ottawa's end, getting some good opportunities. Ouellette's fighting hard for that puck.
And the Duke lost his stick in there as well. Ottawa's finally going to be able to bring it out after that strong forecheck by the Redmen.
Yeah, they'll dump it down, go off for a change, get some fresh legs as the Redmen regroup. Pass up to Laporte. That gets broken up by Fouché. It's been very strong defensively so far for Ottawa. Now Ottawa gets it in to McGill's end. Donovan, some hard play. Bit of a late hit there, and a big takedown. Oh, we're getting a little frisky here.
White getting into it there in the corner. God, it looked like a WWE move there.
Yeah.
Stone Cold Steve Austin. Taking him down.
Oh, another big hit.
And the hits just keep on coming.
White lines up number 22, Duchamp.
These boys are making for one heck of a hockey game so far.
Yeah, we've seen some great scoring chances, some nice goals, some big hits. Oh! Saint-Laurent gets spun around there as Glendon gets his stick caught in his legs, and we're going to have a penalty to Ottawa for slashing. Saint-Laurent certainly not pleased about that.
Ref's voices, God, folks, if you can hear voices over our own announcing at home, it'd be the refs almost yelling at the kids right now. Don't do that! So, like you said, lots of some scoring, some big hits. God, if we had a pizza out here, this might be perfect. We're going to see Ottawa go on the penalty kill again. After building up some momentum strong in the McGill zone.
So third power play for McGill so far, 0-2. See if they can do something here. That's kept in with a kick somehow by McGill defenseman. Now Ottawa gets it out. Regibald, he's been great on the penalty kill for Ottawa. He's on with Ouellette. And they're doing a great job of killing this penalty so far. They've got two deep. An interesting strategy. Redmen ball gains it again. He'll go for a bit of a skate. Kill off more time here. Carrier. Rose. Back to McKiernan. He'll slow it down. Get his team set up. Takes a big shot. Dumps it in.
McGill's moving that puck strongly as they circle it around. Ottawa's got to maintain that strong box formation to keep them at the distance.
Dick picks it up. Beautiful play. And they've got Regibald bringing. Oh, come on. Fans waiting for a penalty shot. We'll see if we get one. The rest still deciding.
Come on. Sorry, I'm getting into it like a fan right now. That was a clear taken down breakaway. And
certainly the requirements for a penalty shot are that you need to not have had a scoring opportunity, and it was taken away by the hook, so he didn't get a shot off because of that hook. I'm sure the Ottawa coach will argue, but
yeah, I'm Renee, you have to excuse me. I have to jump down to the stands and get with these guys right here, because we're all mind blown right now as a penalty shot. But we're gonna see Ottawa make it interesting. 4-on-4 hockey. I love it. Open up the ice.
Yeah, lots of ice to work with here. Ottawa definitely has the momentum right now. Doing a great job on the penalty kill, getting some great chances. Oh, legit! Big hit!
Oh.
Puts Paul Pye into his own bench.
Yes! This is awesome! Ladies and gentlemen, if you're just tuning in right now, we're about midway through the second period, 2-1. McGill over you, Ottawa. And This is an exciting hockey game. Great start to a Friday night for sure.
I don't know what they had for Christmas dinner, but they are playing on fire. We haven't seen this many hits in the entire first half of the season.
I'm thinking maybe these boys got coal in their stockings and they're just upset. Whatever it is, these guys, both teams have come to play.
Got a close game here. Some 4-on-4 hockey. Then Ottawa will go on the power play. Boucher slowing it down, up to Vermette. He gets it out, Ouellette. Over to Regimbault, they're back on. Obviously, coach happy with this penalty killing pair. Regimbault just robbed of that great opportunity. That'll be gloved easily by Shimko, and Vermette doing a good job of keeping the red man to the outside.
Good job on Coach Faymon there for, like you said, Regimbault was back on the ice. Really for a young rookie player stepping in and getting a sign of confidence from your coach saying, get in there, buddy, get it done. It's like, that's awesome. That's going to boost his confidence, and we'll probably see some more results.
Yeah, definitely doing a great job for Ottawa. 13 points so far here in his rookie season. And almost made it 14 there. Face-off in Ottawa's end. That's won by McGill, odd bounce, and Ottawa will recover that. They're on the power play here for a minute. They'll get set up, bring it up. Duchette over to Tanguy Thériault. Blunden. So Ottawa's first power play unit on.
Ooh. Donovan getting roughed up from behind there in the boards. Hope he's okay. No. Oh, swing and a miss. And we got ourselves a breakaway.
Wow. A shorthanded goal there by what looks like number 26, Alexandre Comtois.
That's going to make it a 3-1 hockey game as... Ottawa looks stunned right now. Look at these young GG's players, and they have a stunned look on their face. As a quick breakaway turns into a fan shot, mind you, turns into a breakaway chance, and the Redmen are not going to lose it. So,
yeah, Ottawa is just going to comment, went back to their power play structure of four forwards and one defenseman, and it hurt them there. It's, the Redmen got past Legic and were home free.
And we've got a face-off call right now. And Collins getting roughed up into his own boards as well, just the same way McGill player got thrown into his almost. So, and it's the exciting week in hockey as well this week as Team Canada's roster was announced. Like many Canadians, there's huge debates and all that.
Yeah,
he should be, who shouldn't be there. But as I said, we can all comment it after the Olympics to see if they were right or wrong. So, but God, I wish Stanley Wee was on that team.
Yeah, certainly some interesting calls there by Eiserman, but we'll have to see how it works out.
Okay, two scratch.
In a month, we may be calling him a genius.
Scratch that. They looked great. That's our cameraman's telling us. They admitted two great players, Stan Louis, and I must have had my phone on silent or something like that because I missed the call too. So maybe they'll get called to fill up the water bottles or something like that. And we're gonna have an icing call here. And yes, so over the Christmas break we saw. These boys were lucky not playing hockey. They got to see the Winter Classic and taking some good hockey games. So
with the World Juniors.
I'm in a good mood, Renee. Let's not ruin it.
Good battle there by Ottawa. Touchette fighting hard for the puck. His shot gets blocked. Keeps on it. Blunt in there, fighting in the corner with Lapalte. Touchette comes up with it, over to Vermette, passes it to Fouché. Good puck possession here by Ottawa. Oh, Blunden throws it in front, but no one there. And now sent the other way by McGill. So just over halfway through this game and a 3-1 lead for the McGill Redmen.
Good job for the McGill. Take away those easy passing lanes in front of that net, getting that stick there. Take away some solid scoring chances.
It's broken up by Fouché. McGill pushing hard here. Certainly they've got the momentum back now. Tagliatelle can't quite get it out as it's stepped in by Bernier. And now finally Ottawa. Reginbald having a great second period. Tries to get through on his own, can't quite.
Rough play down the corner there as Bernier went into the boards hard. Ottawa starting to run around right now in their own zone. They need to learn to settle down and stop this pressing Redmen attack.
McKiernan on the point, kind of controlling the play. Calling for the puck when he needs it. And now Ottawa does get it out. But McKiernan picks it up, dumps it in. Both teams will get some fresh legs on the ice. White, Ouellette throws it in the middle, but no one there. And that puck skips on Landry. Gets helped up by Cranville. Rose, he can't quite keep a handle on that, so White picks it up. Nice shot. The puck bounces up, and Saint-Laurent didn't know where it was.
Whitey almost had a goal there.
Oh! White had an empty net. I don't know how he didn't put that in.
I could have parked my car in there. It was so big. But White misses out on a good chance. And
wow.
This is still a 3-1 hockey game.
The puck bounces off the back end right to Matt White sitting in the slot.
And you can see his face after that. And I think he was more disheartened than all of us. So. And Saint-Laurent right now is thinking, whew. Got away that time.
Ottawa's going to take a timeout.
Imagining Coach Paymon trying to regroup his boys. Say, all right, guys, listen. You know, the game's not over until the final whistle's blown. And so, really, tighten those loose screws and figure out ways to get more pressing attack. Because, like we've seen, it's a lot of back and forth hockey. But when McGill gets in our zone, they're in our zone, you know what I mean? So when they got to get in McGill's zone, they have to be able to set up, calm down, set up some solid passing, and really crash that net.
Certainly probably some words of encouragement here from Paymon telling his boys that they're coming close and they got this. This is their opportunity.
I wonder if he has like the big, you know, Al Pacino, Any Given Sunday, big speech going, and motivational music in the background. We'll save that for the locker room, though. Face-off's going to happen now.
White here is going to take the face-off, so White, Gilte, and Donovan certainly going to try get something going. Donovan's shot is wide. Get Gilte fighting for space in front, and now Gilte back to the point. Terrier. Oh! Donovan gets a stick on it. Can't get it past it, Ottawa, good puck possession. Legic steps up, and now we've got 3-on-2. Good back check there by White.
And a questionable call coming up right against Ottawa as Matt White rushed back as Leduc went to play the forecheck. White dropped back to play D, and I think he'll be taking a trip to the sin bin for a hooking call. Tough break for Ottawa.
So the fourth penalty for Ottawa. And so far, the only special teams goal we have is a shorthanded goal by the Redmen. We'll see, maybe Ottawa can do the same. Reginbald certainly was playing great on the penalty kill. But now, got a different line out for Ottawa to start us off. Touchette and Tanguy Thériault. Deep in Ottawa's end. That puck gets shot up and out. Bounds.
And the funny thing, too, our last home game we had, Renee, I was actually got a chance to meet some of the players after the game. And, you know, one thing I was really impressed with is that, you know, we see them on the ice together, you know, the whole brotherhood thing like everyone talks about. It was really cool to see them off the ice. They're all buddies. They're all talking to each other, poking fun at each other. And really, I think that plays a key part into a long season and keeping it together. So
they definitely spend a lot of time with each other, practicing 5 days a week, playing on the weekends, going on road trips. So gotta like each other. As McKiernan here, he'll settle it down, regroup. Touchette's gonna give him some pressure. C'est là, huh? Nice tap on the pads as he goes by.
A little love tap right there for Touchette. Hey buddy, get out of here.
McKiernan brings it up. Missed hit there, and
here comes Donovan on the forecheck.
Donovan goes in on C'est là, huh? Oh! All right, getting feisty with C'est là, huh? Takes out his left leg. No call.
Call me crazy, but I think the most aggressive player on McGill right now is Samara, the guy between the pipes. Do not get in front of him or you'll have a big whack.
Well, I mean, he certainly put his legs out there. He did think Donovan would, you know, do anything to him. Clearly mistaken.
Forecheck here.
30 seconds left in the power play for McGill. So they get it back to the point. Ottawa goes back to their box. Big shot goes wide. Ledic, he'll dump it all the way down. That should be about it for this power play. Blunden catches that, knocks it down, and back to 5-on-5. Yelte. Oh, he gets hit late.
Late
by
hit.
Laporte.
Laporte. Should be shown Laporte for that late hit. But Garrett standing right into the mix of all the hoopla down there. And both teams playing very intensely so far.
I have a face-off here just outside of the McGill end. Ottawa certainly looking for a way to get another puck past. Said, aha, they scored on him early, first 14 seconds, but haven't been able to get one by him since then. Certainly great opportunities from Regenbald. White missed a close one, but still a 3-1 game for the McGill Redmen. That Paul goes back to get that. Regenbald right on him. Yelte, good pressure. Landry dumps it back in. Again, great pressure here from this line for Ottawa. Lahok Malku tries to throw back to the point. He's got that lone goal for Ottawa. And now brought in with speed by McGill. Great passing play there. Duchalm.
McGill's great at taking advantage of those miscues by Ottawa as they can turn into a great offensive rush. And put the pressure on Chimko, who has bounced back from a shaky first period. We had a one goal where he'd like to have back, but he's playing his game the way we know he can play it.
McGill's certainly a team that gets scoring from a little bit of everywhere. For a couple players, lots of players with 5-6 goals. Ottawa, on the other hand, two players with 10 goals so far in the season, both Blunden and Touchette. And here we have another goal for McGill, just batting it in, hard battle in front. Looks like, once again, number 26, Comtois, putting another goal up on the board for McGill.
And McGill is creating bigger distance, making a statement right now as they make it 4-1, and we're going to have a goaltender change. May is coming in for Shimko, as Shimko's night's done. But 4-1 the score with less than 3 minutes to go in the second period here. And this is not the outcome Ottawa was looking for. They need to get back in this game. McGill wins the faceoff. Then we play it up. Fleur pushes it over.
Certainly not the score I expected after seeing the first 5 minutes, but McGill's ready. Wow, that was a wonderful goal. Redmen ball finishes a beautiful play there. Wow, that's the response from Ottawa.
That is what you need, ladies and gentlemen, make that game. Triple deke, 1-2-3, and then a nice little pass off to finish it. We have a 4-2 game. Don't count these GGs out yet. We still got another period to go as Ottawa makes it a two-goal affair now.
Certainly letting McGill know that they can do it too, that quick rush up, and Ottawa's number 26 now getting on the board. Regimbald, his third goal of the season. Carrier back in his own end, hard pressure. See if Ottawa can keep up the momentum here. Lahoque Malcou putting good pressure. And now Comtois, he's got two goals. Pardon me, number 28. The Lil Hood bringing it up. 2 minutes left here in this second as Ottawa trying to close the gap once again. Carrier, he'll just dump it into the corner. Le Duc fighting with Daniel Hood. He's got a goal so far this game.
Ottawa putting that pressure back and trying to force their way into McGill's zone. Touchette, good attempt to keep the puck in using his hand to knock it down, but they're going to be called offside.
So we saw what it takes to get a puck past Sale, huh? Beautiful play like that.
Those are not the easiest things to come by, so.
They only need three more, it's okay.
I meant to put dangles on like that on a daily basis. Could be a little hard unless you're Sidney Crosby, so. It'll be interesting to see.
McGill dumps it in, goes out of play, and we'll have a face-off outside of the Redmen end. Certainly Ottawa looking to keep their momentum going. Something like 8 wins in the past 10 games.
They went for a little rip, I guess you could say, as they've crawled their way back into, after starting the season slow. Oh.
Selaha just falls.
So we got a penalty coming up to Theriault. I think it's going to be a tripping goalie interference.
He barely touched them.
So the bigger they are, I guess, the harder they fall. So, and the fans are letting St. Laurent know how they think about that one. So, Theriault have a little seat for a 2-minute power play for McGill. Again, they're going to be forced, they're going to be surrounding that Ottawa zone. So,
we'll see if bringing in Harrison May gives Ottawa any more jump. Certainly they scored right off when he came in. See if he can help them stay in this. So McKiernan, beautiful shot there. And we have the announcement, last minute of play in the second period. A 4-2 lead for the McGill Redmen over the Ottawa Gigis at the moment on the power play.
Lots of movement going down, some quick passes getting thrown around the ice, really spreading them out.
Got White and Donovan on to kill this. And Ottawa clears it out. So they look back at the clock, see 30 seconds left. Terrier will pick that up, you know, take it for a skate, kill some time. Rose right on him. And Tellier dumps it all the way down. Ottawa is offside because of their change.
Regimbald had to cancel that
attack. And he puts hard pressure on Millet, who runs into Vermette, not looking where he's going.
And McGill fires away, and now end the period 4-2. A very exciting second period here. Mitchell Sports Complex. 20 minutes left of hockey, and we shall see you soon. back for the third and final period here. Men's hockey, CIS. You got the Redmen and the GGs playing. 4-2 is the score with 20 minutes left to play. Aggressive hockey, just lots of hits. Scoring, out of the blue scoring, we've seen some nice goals. And it'll be interesting to see who finishes the game on top because both teams are right in it.
Yeah, we had a goaltending change. After the fourth goal, we've got Harrison May in now for Ottawa's puck drop here. Some great play by rookie Regenbald, and Fouché's been strong on defense for Ottawa. We doubled up on the score in the second period now, 4-2. Two goals by Comtois for McGill, and a goal by Regenbald to try and close the gap. We'll see. The coach was able to light some fire under Ottawa, tie this game up. It's the Redmen here in their own end, going to regroup. McNichol bringing it up and over to Rose. He had the first goal for the Redmen here in this game. He's had a strong game, been laid out a few times. So we've seen some big hits. Vermette knocks that down. Fans on his pass. And now Tanguy Thériault will give chase just out of his reach. Picked up by Touchette.
Touchette's got some speed working in that zone, but Thériault couldn't finish with the clapper.
Yeah, trying to feed him in the middle. Last time these two teams met was a 6-0 win for McGill, so certainly a better outcome already for Ottawa, but they definitely like to at least get a point out of the game. And Taylor had no idea where the puck is.
Nice little dance move to get in there by Touchette, just to sneak his way in. It was beautiful. One thing I've noticed with Ottawa, though, is they're lacking the confidence without the puck. We've seen that in their defensive zone lately. It's just, when they have it, you see those great passes, those nice dekes and stuff, but when they don't have the puck, it's that loss of confidence. They really need to keep that up. Keep their heads in the game and keep the pressure on.
Face-off here in McGill's end. They've done a great job of putting hard pressure on McGill, which is what they need because McGill, again, that breaks out very quickly, turns it into a scoring opportunity, and the ref lies in there yelling that it is an icing. So all the way back to the other end.
Tell you, these refs don't even need to make hand signals today to let us know what they're calling. They talk loud enough we can hear them.
Yeah, certainly making their views known. Tanguy Thériault will try again and once again loses this draw. Be picked up by Millette and can't quite get it out. Ottawa, and the net off again. This must be the 10th time the net comes off its moorings.
That's it. I'm finding the suggestion box here at the Mental Sports Complex and putting in keep the net. Maybe it's a safety thing, The last thing, you don't want to bolt it down. God, imagine flying into, I think, a million miles per hour. That would hurt the head. But tonight we can see both teams are finding ways to, they're trying to knock off each other's games, but all they're doing is knocking the net off its posts. So we're going to have a face-off. The ref's double-checking, making sure the net's on tight for the probably
fifth time
tonight.
I'm sure they noticed it, too.
The players, you can see the players too there. Come on, let's play some hockey. And with the cold weather coming earlier this year, the canals opened up here in Ottawa. So
opened folks, up on New Year's Eve.
So, which is awesome. And lots of pond hockey is going on. So it's a great time to be in Ottawa.
Always a great time to be in Ottawa.
That's true. That is true. It's been here 4 years, and I can agree with that fully. Cameraman giving us a little thug sign, Ottawa represent. So.
Is still working on the net here.
I think the refs are trying to figure out how to make sure it doesn't happen again. But and here we go. We're ready for the face-off. Ottawa looking to get back. They got Leduc and Terrien at the point.
White comes in and he wins that face-off. Ottawa digging in the corner. behind the net here, battling hard for the puck. Both teams fairly aggressive. And McGill brings it up quickly. Coltois trying to go for his third, and that's broken up by Lidzik. And now Messier, he circles around. Nice shot, dead on, and Harrison May takes that.
May's able to wrap that up. Harrison May came into the net to take over for Shimko, who had some rough start to this game with a couple weak goals, but May has been doing well to hold it together and keep strong in front of the net.
Can't really blame Shimko for any of those goals. They were all pretty nice goals. Ouellette moves that out for Regibald, who's certainly been probably the strongest forward for Ottawa so far. He had a great shorthanded opportunity that got broken up. Krahenbill, Ottawa's third defensive pairing on here. Him and Landry.
Landry, good job on Landry. Facing up his defenseman, able to knock that puck away.
McGill captain, Avec, getting right in there. Him and Duchamp. Trying to get something going here.
Making a little poke check out, taking out the Redmen player to break up that offensive attack. And Ottawa's going the other way.
Cranville was trying to dump it in. Couldn't quite get it far enough, and we're going to have an icing call.
Faceoff's going to happen all the way back into McGill's zone. And looking at this crowd right now, Renee, a great turnout. But one thing you notice is a lot of McGill fans here. Parents and fans themselves making the trip into Ontario, but anytime you see people loaded up for a hockey game, that's great to see.
Yeah, nice Friday night road trip. You know, it's not too far to McGill. About an hour and a half from Montreal. So Ottawa here, keeping it in McGill's end. Boucher. His shot was blocked. Now the Redmen bring it up. Millette avoids a huge hit by Fouché and passes it in front. McNichol had a great opportunity, and that goes up high.
Fouché's got a watch right there. He's a great defender and really a stay-home defenseman that we love, but he got caught along the boards there. Couldn't finish his check properly, and that was a two-on-one chance.
Yeah, went for the big hit, and Millette got by him. White in to take the faceoff once again. And that's gloved easily by May.
Some high shots coming from the points now. Working the blocker and the glove here on May. And he's been good to shut the door.
May, kind of the veteran on this team, with Shimko, the rookie, in his first year. They've provided some solid goaltending for Ottawa. McGill moving it around. Well, oh, wow.
Big
shot there. Big rebound, and that gets put into the open net. McGill 5-2.
Starting big rebound was given up right there, and McGill was not covered. And May had really no chance of stopping that one.
Yeah, wide open player there.
Got to give it to McGill. They're taking any goals away. They can score some beauties and some garbage goals. Anything and everything to get in the net. To make this a 5-2 game here in the third period. Certainly Ottawa has to focus up and get into this third period. It's power, I think. No, there'll be no penalty. There's just face-off for the offside.
Ottawa's got their fourth line on here. Haven't seen much of them this game. Trying to get some momentum now. Collins picks it up. He's on here with Leighton and Charles Power, who put some hard pressure there. So Silaha will cover up.
Work it out right now. So we're going to change up for both teams. Face off in the McGill zone.
Certainly we hope that once Ottawa gets rolling again, maybe go on another 9-game winning streak like last time. The first half of the season had some great wins there, and see if they can get back in the groove. Touchette shoots that all the way around his own net. Dumped back in by McGill. May throws it to the corner. Cranville. He gives that away.
Cranville just gave a bad giveaway in his own zone. You have to watch that.
Tanguy Thériault moves that up to Blunden. He kept off the scoreboard tonight, Stephen Blunden. 10 goals on the season so far. Back and forth play here as Fouché picks it up in his own end. Vermette loses control of it. Throws it all the way up. No icing. Ottawa gets some fresh legs on the ice. Once again, the fourth line seeing some time here. Coaching what they can do.
Fouché lost his footing right there with the attempt to keep the puck in, but anyways, it's going to trick all the way down and we'll have an icing call.
And a quick switch here.
The intensity here has kind of died down from that crazy second period. As a little less chippiness from both teams.
Yeah, McGill kind of seems like they've got it in control a bit. And I'm going to wait and see what Ottawa responds with. Regenball throws that into the middle. Ouellette goes to chase it.
Three players going on the boards. Redmen still come out with it.
Dumped in by Duchamp. You're right, he's got some sort of ponytail or something hanging out.
So insane. It's like a ponytail or a bandana or something. It's so cool.
Regenball squished there between two Redmen. Hard pressure by the Redmen D.
McGill right now having their way with Ottawa. Ottawa's letting them come at them and attack right through the neutral zone.
Well, you're right. Much less intensity here in this third period.
Touchette lost his footing and he lost the puck as well as the puck goes in front, but they're able to turn it and crank it the other way.
Tanguy Thériault can't really do anything with it. Throws it in the middle, intercepted, and picked back up here by Blunden. Throws it in front. Thériault is going to keep it in. Bring it around the boards, over to Blunden. And now brought back the other way by McGill. Millette just kind of having his way.
You see it? Like I'm saying, McGill was able to drag three Ottawa players into the boards, play their positions. They have to stick to their positions.
That shot by the Redmen's Neil Blunden, saved awkwardly by May, bounces up in front of him, and then Ottawa's pass, Leduc, intercepted by Laporte at the red line and dumped back in. Ottawa will try again. Leduc's going to take that. Thériault loses the puck to McGill. Ottawa. Oh! White and Gauthier collide. Not going well for Ottawa here at all.
Got to keep your head up there. It's two players took a trip.
White collides with Rose. And a little face wash there for him.
Tell you what, White and Gauthier tonight are getting in all the action.
You can hear Rose there coming up the right side, calling for the puck. He's going to go off now. Boutette's shot right on May. Slow it down a bit for Ottawa.
And, good thing I have my glasses on tonight, Renee. I can't tell if it's McGill Redmen or the Detroit Red Wings with similarities between the jerseys. Just plain. Nothing against the red and white, obviously, but spice it up a bit, you know what I mean? I have a face-off here.
Antonelli there fighting for the puck. Back to the point. Nice shot, and oh! And the net comes off once again. We should keep track of this.
I was going to say a tally. Importance of this game right now, as you can see, two teams that are close in the standings. And we're seeing right now, you know, who can make that jump to better themselves. But McGill certainly taking advantage of this third period and showing Ottawa what's up.
Ottawa here trying to get something going. Just over 10 minutes left in this final period. Certainly McGill trying to keep up with Queens, who is the team to beat. They have only two overtime losses, no regular losses. One of those came to Ottawa, how they started this winning streak. But certainly Queens at the head of the pack with McGill right behind them.
So we know the GG player, we know the GGs can take on the tough teams, like you're saying, they beat Queens and that. But it's those crucial games, it's those clutch games where you got to really buckle down. And, you know, they turned some heads when they had that big streak, but now they got to continue it. Oh, Suchette goes for a little trip as that puck's thrown out.
Good pressure there by Ducharme. Thériault, Tanguy Thériault trying to do with it, something with it. Going to be slowed down by McKiernan. Definitely a great player. He comes from New York. Interestingly, a couple players on McGill team from the USA. They've got three of them.
Well, we know here McGill's a very respected school and it's academics, so it wouldn't surprise me if you have people coming up here from the States to give it a try. I always get a kick out of people that say McGill's the Harvard of Canada. I shake my head at it, but they do a very good, well school and built up, and it's great for them if they can bring some top talent from anywhere to play on their sports teams.
Redmen here, pushing hard. There's a shot from the point from McKiernan that got blocked, and now coming the other way is Ottawa. Ouellette gets just take it out. He's rolling around and gets back up. Reginbald comes it into the corner. Got a 5-2 game here. McGill leading. We're going to have a slashing penalty. Looks like to Ouellette, perhaps.
We're going to see Ottawa go into the sin bin once again for a two-minute penalty.
So six penalty for them so far. It hasn't hurt them. One goal coming at the very end of a power play when they were about to even strength, but really the only special teams action here is a shorthanded goal by McGill.
And McGill sending their own player to the box, though, so it looks like we'll have some 4-on-4 hockey.
Right,
just under 10, just under 10 minutes to go to in the third period. 5-2, down 3. Ottawa's got, I say, there's a lot of hockey left to be played. Wondering if Ottawa has it in them to come back.
So it looks like just a regular 5-on-5. The two calls cancel each other out, perhaps. Seeing a lot more ice time here for Ottawa's fourth line and third defensive pairing. So Coach Piemont trying something different. And we're going to have another penalty here as Gaultier gets taken out. He ends up on the ground.
fans down here in the Ottawa section calling for a spearing penalty as Giratina finds himself. He's having a bit of a rough game, maybe, but he's taking them like a champ. I can tell you that as he's keeping his head up. But
so McGill also had a penalty there for roughing, and now second man goes to the box. So 5-on-4, power play for Ottawa. Didn't go so well for them last time. So McGill scored shorthanded, a goal by Comtois. We'll see.
They'll have to keep this. They'll have to keep this pressure on, and really, Saint Laurent's a big goaltender. You got to put a body in front of him and create some traffic in front of that net and fire some shots on it. You got Leduc out there, great point man, from especially with that shot of his. So
it looks like they're back to their four forwards, one D-man set up with Leduc, the lone defenseman. Got Donovan, Tanguy, Thériault, Touchette, and Blunden out there with Leduc. They're moving it around. Touchette walks in, takes a nice shot, seen all the way by Saint Laurent. Definitely need more bodies in front of the net.
I know he's a feisty. We've seen Saint Laurent's a feisty goaltender. He doesn't take a lot. As maybe that's it. He's keeping guys away from him, doing it on his own. Big, strong goaltender.
Tanguy Thériault wins that face-off. Ottawa gets set up. Once again, Leduc. Over to Shen. Leduc, big shot. That's blocked on the way. He keeps it in, though. Oh! Hit from behind there on Tanguy Thériault. Gets knocked down. And Leduc's pass intercepted. Clears the zone. Comtois all over to Shen. Now he'll regroup. Blending going to try and enter the zone. Sends it back. Tanguy Thériault sends it around. Donovan playing the point with Leduc. Fans yelling for a shot here, and oh, great opportunity there for Ottawa.
Donovan playing the point while he's getting those shots off, and there's a high stick that's waved off, I guess, on Leduc.
Tanguy Thériault in the middle, passes it over to Blunden. Can't put it back to Saint Laurent. Ottawa definitely getting some great chances here. Oh, Saint Laurent fighting through that.
Oh, and
Laporte just puts a headlock there on the Ottawa player. We've got a little skirmish going on.
Oh my God, that was a... I've heard of, you know, clearing from the net, but never have I seen somebody just could be in a headlock, put you in the sleeper hold and take you down. As Laporte getting in again with the dirty stuff.
The ref separating all the players here, sorting that out.
Ottawa getting some fresh legs out there. Some good solid passing work on this power play we've seen so far, but can't capitalize as Saint Laurent's been shutting the door every time.
Ottawa here, power. So the fourth line going to see some power play time. We've got
May's going to play it safely.
Yes. Collins, power. Larocque, Marcou. And Redmen ball. So an interesting look here for Ottawa as the power play is over. Great play by Larocque Marcou to get around everyone, throws it in front, and no one there to pick it up. So Comtois and Tinelli breaking in. Larocque Marcou will pick it up again. Throws it into the middle. No one there. Redmen ball giving chase. That gets shot in, and May will stop that. Terrien shoots that around, gets hit hard. And the Redmen kind of skating around Ottawa here. Boutet keeps it in. Antonelli to Rose. Over to Carrier. That'll be stopped by May, who jumps right on that.
And you can see McGill really working that offensive prowess right now. Some nice passing. They'll set up for great opportunities. As Ottawa's seen in their own zone again, facing that pressure and really running around. The puck is about to be dropped. And it's out, finally, as McGill's able to knock it back in as Leduc races into the boards. Vermette's calling for the puck. Gets over. And they're off. White loses control, plays it back to Leduc. And here comes Layton, moving the puck into the Redmen zone, fires it on. Saint-Laurent blocker save.
McGill moving it up here. White dumps it in. Just under 6 minutes to play. A 5-2 lead for McGill. They've had a goal by Rose, two goals by Delille Good, and two goals by Comtois in this game. Ottawa's goals coming from Lahoc-Marcou in the first 15 seconds and Regimbald in the second. Millet here throws it across, almost intercepted by Tanguy Thériault.
Good job on Tanguy Thériault getting ready in there, pressuring that puck, making Miguel fight for it.
That's knocked aside by Saint-Laurent. Nice wraparound attempt there. And that's brought up by Millet, who's stopped at the line by Landry. They still gain the zone. McNichol. Oh, nice give and go there.
Excellent job by Vermette by picking up the open man and taking away the opportunity.
Delilhood and McNichol playing well together.
Glove was thrown on the ice by Laporte, so it lost control of it. The puck is controlled. Ottawa waiting for them to make the first move. And seeing this all night, as McGill's able to come out with it and make it through.
Comtois racing in. He was looking for his third of the night. Ouellette brings it up. And I'll get sent all the way back down. It'll be an icing call.
We're going to have a face-off down in the McGill zone. Less than 5 minutes to go in the third period. Interesting to see if Ottawa can score four quick ones to take advantage and win this game. But we have seen a little lack of slow stutter in their step right now, as they've not been attacking as fiercely as they were in the first two periods of this hockey game.
Definitely the wind's gone out of their sails, and they started off very strong and have just slowly been overwhelmed by McGill's speed and quick attack. So McGill just passing it around here, coming through the neutral zone. Dumps it in. So we brought up Vermette. Up to Blunden. His shot goes wide. Pompey brings it in. Nice pass across and looks to get it back. Dips it wide. And then that comes off once again.
Good job on May, able to slide across to make the save, and even taking Pompey out of the play himself. So I give credit to Harrison May right now. He's been playing very well since coming in for Shimko and providing that backbone that Ottawa needs to keep themselves in this hockey game.
Yeah, came in just under the 3 minute mark in the second with 3 minutes left, and for the past 20 minutes he's been solid, only letting in one goal. Some hard Redmen pressure. Leduc tries to catch the puck, falls down. Well, it looked like a very awkward play.
You stick to using the stick, boys. This is not baseball. Catch it.
Exactly what it looked like, running back to catch that ball.
Getting some mix up here.
Comes in to take the face off, wins it back to Boutet. Over to Carrier. So, I mean, we certainly had an exciting, fast-paced game. Some big hitting by Ottawa. Some great goals. But ultimately, looks like McGill will just prove too much. Ottawa perhaps needs to work on 60 minutes of hockey, full intensity. because there were definitely times when they had the upper edge.
And Antonelli of McGill right now trying to get in the face of Harrison May. And looking at these players right now, and you can see a bit of a sense of defeat as they're kind of looking a bit slow right here. And this is prime time to get back in this hockey game.
They'll have a chance to redeem themselves tomorrow night. They play once again at home, 7 p.m. UOIT.
Well, it's not over until it's over, so hopefully they can get back in this game. But that, like you said, they have another game coming in tomorrow night. And the net is, I'll give you, it's knocked off again. As Ottawa tried to get in on that offensive check.
Certainly should be a good game. The last time Ottawa played UOIT, they won it 8-2. So we'll see if we get another high-scoring affair. It's always exciting for us up here in the booth.
You know, I think we get into it more than some of the fans out there. So McGill not taking any chances as they load up three players in front of the net as the faceoff. Kind of a penalty here coming to, oh no, oh.
To penalty, McGill, yeah, and May was going to the bench and he played that. So Ottawa gets a six man on. The dick, big shot, and it blocked by his own player. Donovan got in the way of that. It's a nice shot by the dick.
LeDuc letting a howitzer come from the point. But we're going to see Ottawa go on the power play right now. Kudos to May as he was skating to the bench to get the extra attacker on. The puck was trickling down, and he gave it a little pass the other way just in case it rolled into the net. It's happened before, so.
So with exactly 2 minutes to go, McGill takes a two-minute penalty. So Ottawa will spend the rest of the game on the power play, unless they score, of course. Nice play broken up there by Legic, and now odd man rush the other way. Try to pass it across to Blunden. And Ottawa can't quite.
Redmen are bringing it out again.
Wow.
And that is a goal on the 2-1 chance.
Passes it around the sprawling Legic over to the open forward, who was not that open. Pretty covered and still manages to put it into the net.
You're
past
right.
Harrison May.
You are right, Renee, as that makes it 6-2 with less than 2 minutes to go in the third period here between McGill and Ottawa. For the first home game back, it's not the performance they've been we're looking for, especially a statement game against McGill like tonight. But
well, that's two short-handed goals for McGill. So certainly not the special teams that Coach Kamai wants to see.
Well, I guess the best short-handed team, a good short-handed unit, instead of just getting the puck out, they're able to get the puck in the other net.
So that goal scored short-handed by number 9, Max Nasir. So we're in the last minute of play here. A valiant effort by Ottawa. Came out strong right away, but couldn't quite keep up with McGill's speed. Definitely needs to go back to the drawing board, work on some things.
That puck's going to roll. No icing call. May's going to play it. Nice pass up. But McGill's able to take it away. Moving the puck now is in the Ottawa zone. McGill is not giving up on this strong forecheck.
So Ottawa 2-1 since the season's restarted here in 2014. Two losses and a win. They dropped to 11 wins, 7 losses, and 1 overtime loss here. 23 points. We'll have to see what they can do tomorrow against UOIT. As that is the end of the game, a 6-2 win for the McGill Redmen.
6-2 final score. Not the performance they're looking for, but Hats off to these boys. They played 60 minutes of hockey. Well, technically they played 60 minutes of hockey, but tonight that was not the 60 minutes they wanted. So they'll go back to the drawing board and be back out tomorrow night. And we'll be back tomorrow night as per usual. I'd like to thank everyone for tuning in for another great broadcast here on SSN. From Richard and Renee, good night, guys. Drive safe, and we'll see you tomorrow.